Welcome back. Hailed as the mother of all army units in the country, the Madras Regimental Centre at Wellington in the Nilgiris district celebrated its 253rd racing day today. A solemn raid laying ceremony at the War Memorial to remember war heroes was followed by an impressive Sainik Sammelan held at the historic Sri Nagesh Barracks, where the officers and Jawans rededicated themselves to the defence of the country. A 2 lakh rupee cash award was presented to one of the 26 Levin heroes, P.V. Manish, who is still part of this regiment. Also, more than 200 officers and Jawans voluntarily donated blood to mark the occasion.
Today, we celebrate the 253rd years of raising of the Madras Regiment. The Madras Regiment, as you know, was first organized by Robert Clive of East India Company in 1758 on 4th December. We have a long history of 252 years wherein the Madras Regiment and the Madras soldiers have won many battles and brought glory to the country and defended the country in all frontiers, be it northeast, north, or even in south, as also overseas.
What is a weekend without that sample of entertainment? And this one's a picture worth 1,000 words. The dirty picture finally hit the screens on Friday, and the Vidya Balan starrer seems set to shatter box office records. But will the dirty picture prove to be a game changer for the women in Bollywood? We will just find out.
Balaji Telefilms stock up 35 to 40% over the last week and up a further 10% on this filmy Friday. In the process, setting the stock of the two women behind the dirty picture soaring higher.
I think the boys are of course going to love the dirty picture because it is dirty.
The Dirty Picture opened with 80 to 100% collections, begging the question, will the Dirty Picture be the game changer women in Bollywood have been waiting for?
I think the bias will go surely and steadily. I think there will be more movies and the game will change. I think next year there will be no hegemony of the male stars, and thank God.
While the Bollywood fraternity and critics are united for once as they gush over Vidya, viewers too can't seem to stop saying ooh la la la.
Ooh la la, ooh la la, ooh la la, ooh la la, tu hai meri fantasy.
Super hit.
Super hit.
Super hit.
Super hit.
Super hit.
Ooh la la.
Ooh la la.
Ooh la la. Some ooh la la.
Kya wala is hot.
Though it did take a female viewer to point out a flaw.
It's good, but then it's more about fashion only.
But even with a little criticism coming her way, it's clear that Vidya, with her silk act, could just have opened the way for heroine-oriented cinema in Bollywood. NDTV Bureau Report.
December is that month that spells all of the music, raga, sabhas and art in its true splendid form. If you are in Chennai city, be it those kacheris or even the arangetrams, the Mylapore Dance Academy witnessed a kacheri by Ms. Sridevi, a student of Padma Shri Sudha Rani Raghupati, and left the audience left truly enthralled. Every single year, this season has been the most awaited one by all the art lovers across the world.
I think it's something that the world looks up to, from different part of the world, there's so many people who come in here to watch dancers and musicians here, and they're all enthralled by our performances, and I'm really glad that I got an opportunity to dance this year.
It's December and Chennai turns into a kacheri capital, but it's not all about celebration of the traditional art form. The city also boasts of an ever-increasing fan base for the Western form of dance. Here is how some Chennaites are gearing up to give you a shock treatment. This is the den of the dance crew named Fifth Element. Practice sessions are on in full swing for Shock, the biggest and most awaited annual Western dance competition. The competition was started in 2003 by a few dance enthusiasts as a platform
for professionals to showcase their ability to shake a leg. The training sessions for the competition begins months before the competition. Every step is carefully choreographed to achieve a highly sophisticated move. Most groups even practice at the Marina Beach to perfect their backflips and handstands.
Choreographing for these guys take a little bit of a lot of work because we have a lot of competition these days, right? So they put in a lot of hard work and thinking, mixed combination of work, and that's how they choreograph. And these guys put a lot of effort when it comes to competitions like shock and everything, where we have classes going on during the day, and in the nights they have night practice all throughout.
A prize money of 50,000 rupees is what these dancers would get for winning the competition. But the dancers feel that ending up as a winner gives them the real kicks rather than the monetary gain. In Chennai, with Nikita, this is Anu George Kanjanathopul for NDTV Hindu.
And with that, News Tonight comes to an end. This is Anu George Kanjanathopul for NDTV Hindu. Have a good night.